Can we turn AI videos into 3D models? Can OpenAI Sora solve the problem of text to 3D? In this video, I want to first show you how to go from video to 3D using Gaussian splatting and then share my own thoughts as a machine learning researcher. We download a video generated by Sora, then go to Polycam's website and choose Gaussian splatting. Log in, upload the video, and wait for a few minutes, and then we have the video here. The first view was kinda cool. The whole model has a lot of small pieces, not that continuous. Let's try another one. This Japanese street model, also fragmented. It has some details, still not that ideal. I think this is because the camera moves forward in the videos, aka tracking shots. Let's think about algorithms like nerve and Gaussian splatting. They require a bunch of image views around the subject.
We sample a camera pose uniformly.
So let me try some arc shots or having the camera rotating around the subject. We can only pick from Sora's existing demos because it's not open to the public yet. This one looks so relevant. The original video was not 360 degrees, so the model is limited too. And this one, I thought we've generated good results, but then the output doesn't make sense at all. To answer the original question, yes, as we see, some of the AI videos can be converted to 3D models. For Polycam, it might have sampled uniformly from the input video to create the multi-views, as if these photos were taken at the same time. Then, it applies Gaussian splatting to compute the 3D representation in the latent space. How good the 3D conversion is depends on a few factors. First, I believe the most important is the video's 3D consistency. An object needs to maintain its shape and color even from different angles or at different time points. If AI-generated videos do not preserve the trait, then it will be hard to put together inconsistent information about the 3D object. Second, we want the subject not moving a lot itself. Remember the assumption, the views are treated as if they're taken at the same time. It's like when we use iPhone's panorama to stitch images.
Did something fall on you and flatten your face?
Third, the conversion has some limitations from the algorithm used, for example, Gaussian splatting or nerve. It will be hard if the subject is transparent. Also, if we want stylized 3D models, then the video generation pipeline needs to be able to generate certain art styles. This shouldn't be challenging as long as we have such training data. Can text-to-video models like Sora solve the problem of text-to-3D? From a technical perspective, there is a possibility. Right now, we see the scenes are not that great for 3D modeling. But remember, these AI videos were for Sora's demo purposes, not specifically for 3D reconstruction. Also, I only used the basic version of Gaussian splatting via Polycam, but there were many other great methods to perform 3D reconstruction. In the future, the results will look much better with new algorithms and category-specific treatments. Another difference I want to point out is all the videos we tried generate 3D scenes, and they're different than individual 3D objects. In my previous video, I mentioned that 3D modeling is widely used in the gaming industry. They appreciate having clear 3D objects with clear topologies. Machine learning models like Sora can't do this yet, so it may not fit that well into the gaming industry's needs. Generating 3D scenes is still a big step, and it will be super helpful because right now, there are not many algorithms to generate 3D scenes from scratch, like without scanning any real objects. In practice, game devs adopt a mainly procedural approach, placing existing 3D models at calculated locations. The new video to 3D approach will make it easier to create 3D scenes good for movies, etc. I'm not a camera pro, but technically, directors can generate a virtual space by AI and use a camera in a 3D rendered scene for filming. Besides research, startups' actions are reflecting the tie between video versus 3D generation too. Luma allows people to scan objects using their smartphones and remix the 3D models. They recently hired a researcher from Google's text-to-video team of VideoPoint. Is Luma planning something in video generation? We'll see. Gemmo AI, another AI startup, started with AI 3D. They soon shifted focus to text-to-video generation. Their founders are top researchers in AI 3D. I wouldn't be surprised if one day they come back to the 3D generation space again. If you're interested in AI, especially video and 3D generation, you can follow me and let's explore together. See you next time!